that caught national attention is garnering even more tonight. Police in Alabama shared an update today on the disappearance and return of Carly Russell.
You may remember that name. It went viral when she disappeared after calling 911 to report a toddler walking alone on the side of the highway late Thursday. She was gone for more than 48 hours, returning home on foot Saturday night.
Now, questions are swirling to the validity of many parts of the situation, both of Russell's finding an allegedly wandering child and where she may have been during the 48 hours that law enforcement was searching for her.
Police in Alabama now saying that they couldn't find evidence of any child anywhere, and her report remains the only one despite lots of vehicles passing in that area. Police also say neither the snacks that Russell had bought at a nearby Target nor things that she had allegedly taken from where she worked were anywhere found in her vehicle, despite her cell phone and her wig being left behind.
Now, police did stop short of accusing Russell of outright lying and say they want to speak with her again.
WFXR's Amari Williams joins us live from Blacksburg tonight after speaking with a law enforcement expert. Amari, a lot of things we still really don't know.
Yes, Kathleen, Drew, I spoke with a criminologist and former police officer who says we can't be sure of anything until investigations are complete. He does say there are serious implications if anyone is found lying to law enforcement.
Police officers are going to treat missing persons as being valid, as being real, until they determine otherwise.
Police say the ongoing investigation into Carly Russell's disappearance is sparking a lot of questions. Investigators say they've only spoken to Russell once, right when she returned home, but say they haven't been able to verify a lot of the claims she made then, but they are still looking into things. In any case, former police officer Dr. Todd Burke says it's an offense to report false information to law enforcement, especially during a missing case report.
We're spending all this time, all this money, and it's often more than one agency. So you're talking about a lot of resources that are there, and what they could charge the person with is filing a false report.
Burke says in today's world, police resources and related agencies are often limited and stressed as it is. That's often why they require that people have been missing for 24 or sometimes up to 48 hours, depending on the condition they're believed to be in. Burke says if a person is lying about an incident, more resources will be used to find out why.
And that's why the police are investigating. They want to find out, you know, how the person ended up missing, why they were missing, and if it proved not to be true, why it was not true.
Now again, investigators have only said that they haven't been able to verify her initial claims, and they just want to speak to her again. They say that there is no reason for the public to be in any danger. They didn't find any reason for the public to be in danger at this time. Live in Blacksburg, Imari Williams, WFXR News.